The Unfolding of God's Plan, Dispensations and the Pauline Ministry. The Bible, specifically the King James Version, KJV, reveals how God interacts with humanity through different periods called dispensations. Each dispensation showcases a unique way God communicates His will and offers salvation. 1. The Dispensation of Innocence. God created Adam and Eve in His image, Genesis 1:27, and placed them in the Garden of Eden with one command: "But of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, thou shalt not eat," Genesis 2:17. Their disobedience by eating the forbidden fruit, Genesis 3:6, ended this period of innocence. 2. The Dispensation of Conscience. After the fall, humanity was guided by conscience. Cain's murder of Abel, Genesis 4:8, exemplified increasing wickedness. "And God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth," Genesis 6:5. God sent the flood as judgment, sparing only Noah and his family, Genesis 7:1. 3. The Dispensation of Human Government. Post-flood, God established human government. He instructed Noah's family, "Be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth," Genesis 9:1. Humanity's attempt to build the Tower of Babel, Genesis 11:4, led God to confound their language and scatter them, Genesis 11:7, 8. 4. The Dispensation of Promise. God called Abram, saying, "Get thee out of thy country unto a land that I will show thee," Genesis 12:1. He promised to make of him a great nation, Genesis 12:2. This covenant continued through Isaac and Jacob, laying the foundation for Israel. 5. The Dispensation of Law through Moses. God gave the law, and He gave unto Moses 2 tables of testimony, Exodus 31:18. The 10 commandments, Exodus 21:17, and other statutes governed Israel's conduct. Despite this, the Israelites often rebelled, revealing the law's inability to bring complete righteousness. 6. The Dispensation of Grace. God sent His Son, Jesus Christ, fulfilling prophecy and the law. "Think not that I am come to destroy the law, but to fulfill," Matthew 5:17. Jesus preached repentance and the kingdom of God, offering salvation through grace. "For by grace are ye saved through faith," Ephesians 2:8. After His resurrection, He instructed His disciples, "Go ye therefore and teach all nations," Matthew 28:19. The Pauline ministry, Saul of Tarsus, later known as Paul, was pivotal in spreading the gospel to the Gentiles. His conversion on the road to Damascus, Acts 9:3-6, led to his mission. "He is a chosen vessel unto me to bear my name before the Gentiles," Acts 9:15. Paul emphasized that salvation is not by the law, but through faith in Jesus Christ. He wrote, "There is neither Jew nor Greek, for ye are all one in Christ Jesus," Galatians 3:28. Paul's letters explain the mystery that Gentiles are fellow heirs, that the Gentiles should be fellow heirs by the gospel, Ephesians 3:6. This current dispensation focuses on grace extended to all, regardless of heritage. 7. The Dispensation of the Kingdom. The Bible speaks of a future kingdom where Christ reigns, and the Lord shall be king over all the earth, Zechariah 14:9. Revelation describes a 1,000-year reign, and they lived and reigned with Christ 1,000 years, Revelation 20, verse 4. Conclusion: from innocence in Eden to the grace offered through Christ, the dispensations reveal God's unfolding plan. The Pauline ministry underscores that salvation is available to all who believe. "For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved," Romans 10:13. This narrative, grounded in the King James Version Bible, invites everyone to partake in God's eternal plan through faith in Jesus Christ.